all-time good guys, certainly splits time as one of our analysts, but you wanted this fight. Man, did you do a lot with it. Congratulations on an epic performance.
He's going to cry.
No, I got my eye poked.
Oh, okay. Hey. I'm gonna say, he's going to cry.
That's my home.
That's what we all say, Michael.
That's my home. This is my second home, and it's good to be back up here with you guys, man. This is my first fight in almost a year. Came back and took a main event, and I got a lot of improvements to make. I'm ready for big fights.
You dominated a guy who is second only to George St. Pierre on the all-time UFC welterweight wins list. I know that is not lost on you. You wanted this fight. Pivot from three rounds to five. How did it play out relative to your expectations going in?
It played out exactly how I thought. Neil's as tough as they come, man. He keeps coming. I remember going into round four, I was pretty tired, and he tried to jump the gun and meet me in the middle. I was like, hey, you wait for the ref, buddy. But super tough guy. And this was a good test for me, man. If I want to be a champion, I got to prove I can go five rounds. I got to prove I can push through fatigue in those tough battles. He got me in some tough positions. You know, that inverted triangle he had on me
definitely
had me worried. So I have a lot to build off of here, and I'm ready to have the year I was supposed to have last year. I got a win in January. I'm ready for two more fights. I called my shot again, same one I called last year. I'm ready for big fights.
Could have been a clean sweep, 4-1, though, across the board in terms of the judges' scorecards. You mentioned improvements, though. I know you're digesting this result, but what didn't you like?
Just the fatigue. You know what I mean? I was ready, very well prepared to go three hard rounds, and I pushed hard pace for those first three. And, you know, I was prepared for five, but getting the call on 3 weeks to step up into a main event, my first fight in a year, you know, and it wasn't even brought to my attention until somebody brought it up when I'm sitting at Holiday Inn doing my interviews and like, hey, are you worried about this being a main event after a year layoff? I'm like, oh, damn, I didn't even think about that. Pardon my language, but I feel like I passed the test. Put me in the top five.
Well, how much confidence does that give you, though, now that you are calling out these bigger names, you want these bigger fights, you've proven, yes, I can go five rounds with a guy who's a cardio machine. I mean, I imagine that's got to give you a lot of confidence.
Gives me a lot of confidence, Paul, but I think in my downtime, I'm going to be hitting you up for those workouts.
Hey, man.
Maybe hit you up on Zwift, get some cycling
in.
I got to build my base, man. I've proven time and time again through my career, I can go three hard rounds. But I got to get that championship base. I got to get the Daniel Cormier base. I got to get that Paul Felder base. I got to get that base to go five rounds all the time. A lot to work on, but I'm very happy with the win.
Well, you talked about wanting to stay busy. You want to have the year you wanted to have in 2020. How did the body feel? You know, you had some injuries that you said you had to kind of repair. How did it hold up?
Dude, this is the best I felt pretty much my whole UFC career. This is an injury I've had damn near my whole life, ever since I was 16 years old. And finally getting that taken care of, man, I just was able to push through the camp, not have any hip issues, not have any knee issues. I've been dragging my leg around like I'm a 16-year-old man for 16 years. So I'm able to walk up on my 2 feet with good posture, push through my workouts, recover well structurally. I'm pretty sound. I'll be ready to go two more times this year.
Mike, after a win in the new division, you start calling for Colby Covington. Colby Covington can kind of turn his nose up and say, you know, he just got here. But after beating Rafael Dos Anjos and then beating Neil Magny, it's much more real. How realistic do you think it is that you see a Colby Covington, or do you feel like there's going to be another one before you get to the Colby Covington fight?
Hey, if he wants to sit on the shelf and not fight Waver Hoy Masvidal, go for it. But I'm giving him an opportunity to compete. I'm giving him an opportunity. I'm not waiting for him. I'm the one giving him an opportunity. I'm more active than he is right now. If he wants to sit and wait for Game Bread, good for him. But you just got a guy fresh off a big win, trying to get a fight with you. If he wants to sit and wait for him, go ahead. I'll move on. You got Leon Edwards and Hamzat fighting. You got Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, who had a great fight. Just anybody from five and above, you know what I mean? We got to let this division play out a little bit. And I got work to do, but I got fights to take, and I want to end this year's number one contender.
You were calculated in your desire to fight Neil Magny. Why is Colby Covington the guy some would suggest, matchup-wise, stylistically, that might be one of the tougher fights for you in the top five?
You want to be the best, you got to beat the best. And sometimes the best guy is the one that's the worst matchup for you. You know what I mean? He is the toughest matchup for me stylistically. He will get into my head. There's a mental challenge when you face Colby Covington. And I'm here to test myself. I didn't get in this sport for anything less than to challenge myself. I want to fight the best guys. And if I can't beat the best guys, at least I can say I went for it. So I'm striving to climb to the top. I want to be the best in the world. I'm not going to take the easy route. I'm going the hard way, and I'm looking for the hard route to the top. You know, I'm giving him the opportunity to compete against me if he wants to take it.
Before we let you fly, I'm a little bit emotional over here. I met you at the Ultimate Fighter Live House in 2012. Took you a while to find the right weight class, and maybe you were almost a victim of your success at 55, and that's what delayed it. But you certainly look like one of the best welterweights in the world tonight.
It's been a good ride, John. 9 years you and I have been on this road together, and it's been great having you call my fights. And now that I get to kind of step into your world and stand next to you at the desk with you and these great human beings, this journey's been great, man, and it's an honor to be working with you guys.
I think I speak for most of the MMA masses. Richly deserved. We're very happy for you. Safe travels home, and enjoy some champagne tomorrow morning.
And I love you, Mom. I love you, Kelsey Joe. 509 Spokane represent. Love you guys.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.